in 3 years. Till then, UPSC would be survived. Okay, good. Uh-huh. That's very good. There are many students who start in first year, second year. Okay, so how many of you gave IAS last year? Any of you? No. You all are graduate?
Yes.
Some of you are PG? Anyone who is PG here? Okay, how many of you are science graduate? Engineer, engineers? And arts graduate? Okay, and professionals? Good. Just to tell something what is required in IAS, what we are going to offer and what we have to do. In the next few days, we are going to start a portion of general studies to begin with Indian history, right? And maybe tomorrow itself, or maybe day after tomorrow. First, I have to tell what we are offering and what you must do and what we must do together. Okay? Now, as you all know, the scheme of IAS is for 21 to 32 for general and for reservation. There are certain different ages for Kashmiris. There is some extension of 5 years to the best of my knowledge. Okay? Then, subject wise, what option you have to offer, I will talk tomorrow. How to choose? Optional. There are certain scientific methods through which one should choose option. An option is like a life partner. You cannot take it casually as generally the boys take for girlfriend and girls take boyfriend. And you keep change. Okay, 500 marks is allotted for optional, and it is one of the most decisive factors. Of course, GS, SA, interview, all matters a lot. Now, that I will talk tomorrow. Today, I am going to talk first about GS in general and IAS exam in particular. Okay? When I say IAS, I mean civil services. I hope you know. IAS is one component out of 24 services offered by UPSC. Okay? What they look, what UPSC is looking. Luckily, I am involved in multiple places, including central universities, some state universities, and private institutions, involving myself with former UPSC chairmen, members, and some senior bureaucrats. Those who regularly visit UPSC sit with us in the evening or Saturdays and Sundays for mock interviews. They are with us for real interview. They are in Shah Jahan Road. You know Shah Jahan Road? What? Thoughtful house. That is what first hurdle you have to go for UPSC interview. That is the building, Shah Jahan Road, near India Gate. And your destination first should be Mussoorie or Hyderabad or New Delhi. You know why these three names I mentioned? Mussoorie for IAS. Hyderabad for IAS. And New Delhi for IAS. Kasturba Gandhi. These are the three most coveted services. For other service, I call job, custom, income tax, railway. I don't give too much value because what you can make an impact in the life of ordinary citizen of India, the most vulnerable, downtrodden, backward, Dalit, tribals, and women. That is through IAS. In fact, every good student must aspire and do his or her best for IAS, not for any other service. There are 200 posts on an average. 100 reserve, 100 general, plus minus 20 posts every year. No service in the world can match the kind of exposure IAS gives in 30-35 years. Since I am a student of history, so I know how it evolved in the days of Cornwallis, Curzon and Minto's and others, and how it evolved after independence. The role is ever expanding. And in the new democratic India, its role is more challenging and very interesting. It is more delivery system to reach out to those section of the society which has been deprived since last 2000 years. Kind of regard and respect you would get, no other service can provide with authority. You know, authority means you have constitutional validity for your job. Okay, and of course, pays and perks and other facilities that you may not. For this service, what they look? Why these people are special? Because they are going to test two sides of your brain, left and right, through different testing methods like objective type, subjective type, and interviews. Through various parts of general studies like history, geography, eco, polity, science, state, international affairs, social issues, etc. But primarily they are checking two parts of your brain. The left part keep all your memories, all your data, which you read, which you listen, which you hear. The right part is the analytical mind. It is here where wisdom lies. It is here where emotional intelligence of a person lies. And they are going to check in all the three exams whether this is fully developed or not. If somebody has this full developed, and this empty, he or she is called half mind. And what is this term half mind? In Northern India, half mind we generally call with poor IQ. Okay? But actually the half mind means this, that he or she has remembered all the data, facts and figures, but do not know how to use it. So how the questions in general studies, essay and interview they would design, just giving an example. In most of the GS portion, they would ask, first part, in the format of what, why, when, etc. For instance, in Article 19, there are six freedoms, right? That includes freedom of expression and thought. So they would ask, what is in Article 19? That is available in every book, every material. Second part, something which happened recently, like some students were arrested in JNU for speaking against something. Have you noticed that? Two girls were arrested in Maharashtra for writing blog when Bal Thackeray died. Hope you remember this. And then UPSC same year asked a question based on Article 19, 1A, freedom of expression and thought. So that means, are you aware what is happening related to this article in the last 1 year in India and world? And last, what in your opinion? What do you think? What do you suggest? Which part this is checking? This part. Now, maximum marks is allotted here. Least is here. So out of say a marks allotted for a question 12 and a half or 200 words. If you have answered this, you would get 2. If you have answered this, you would get 2. If you have answered this, you can straight away get 4. Now, this is where most students have not understood what exactly UPSC expects from a student. Now, if you ask any student, I have all the interviewers' questionnaire in my mobile who are giving every day interviews going on in UPSC. The students are preparing current affairs, preparing general knowledge, and how they are asking. I'm just giving you one example. 1 week back, one of my students, he is from Araria, a place in North Bihar, studied in DPS Mathura Road, and then Hansraj College here in Delhi University. He is with us in Jamia. And his address and the board was Chhatar Singh. Is the chairman, one of the members of UPSC, his former IE is from Haryana. So his address was like this, Muharram Colony, Chitragupt Nagar. You're getting it now? So the chairman asks, you have a very secular name of your colony and it helps in national integration. How would you respond? Now, this kind of question he would have never imagined. Anywhere in the world, no coaching institute would tell. And he replied very well. And then he talked and kept talking on national integration. And it lasted 5 minutes only on national integration. imagine, starting from this address that we call DAF, detail application form. What actually that boy had, this one. I remember one of my students some 8-9 years back from Bengal. His name is Ajay Modi. Okay, so he had history and commerce as his option. In those days, you know, two options. You have to write 600 marks each. So he had history with me in some coaching institute as an optional. When we gave mock interview, we realized that his hobby, he has written poetry, Bengali. So obviously one poet, it's very obvious that they may ask in interview, guess which poet? Rabindranath Tagore. So all the board members here at Rajendra Nagar, they said that please read carefully because Tagore is a very versatile person. He was not only a poet, but he was a prose writer, you know, short story, Kabliwala. He was a musician, you know. He was a great educationist. He had opened Vishwa Bharati, Shanti Niketan, a new model of education. He also was first Nobel laureate in Asia. I hope you know that, for Gitanjali, 1913. He was not a nationalist, internationalist. He opposed nationalist idea. And then there is a debate between Tagore and Gandhi, live debate on various issues. They didn't agree on many issues. So the panel members suggested him to prepare from all kinds. Now when he went in UPSC, they asked a question on Tagore, but none of these. The question was, do you know that Tagore was 14th son of his parent? Do you know this? You know. His father was a great social reformer, Devendranath Thakur, who had worked with Rajaram Munra. His first son was Satendranath Tagore. The British called Thakur as Tagore because they couldn't pronounce Tha. So they pronounced Thakur as Tagore. It's an anglicized version. Like Gangopadhyay, so they called Ganguly. Chattopadhyay, Chatterjee, Mukhopadhyay, Mukherjee, Bandopadhyay, Banerjee. So it was all British who started calling, like they started calling Muslims as Mohammedans. The Muslims never called themselves Mohammedans. They even today do not call. The British started calling them as, even for the Hindus, the British started calling them as. The Hindus were never used for a religion in ancient or medieval history. That you would learn in my class. So the question was, the Tagore was 14th son of his parent, do you know? He said, yes sir, I know. And he started counting 1, 2, 3, all the way. They said, no, we're not interested. Question is, imagine if there was a family planning in those days. Tagore being the 14th, India would have missed a great poet. Are you kidding? Not. Tagore's number? 14. And family planning? Hum do, hamar Hindu. So, India would have missed a great poet. Yes or not? Yes or not? Yes or not? Yes or not?
Yes.
If you say yes, answer is wrong.
Yes.
Yes or not?
Yes.
If you say yes, answer is wrong, as I said. If you say no, answer is wrong. Now this is what they were checking, not this knowledge. So he prepared this, not this. Because he studied history. I told you, his paper was history and commerce. He was a chartered accountant. As a rule, in history, we only discuss something which happened. We can never discuss something which could have happened. This question was hypothetical. Had there been a family planning, what could have happened? It is like saying, had not Gandhi arrived from South Africa? Had British not arrived, then what would have happened to railways? Had partition not took place in 47, you are getting not. So those who do not have sense of history, they ask this question, kaash partition nahi hota. If kaash nahi hota, samajh mein aata. Agar partition nahi hota, to kya hota? Yeh sawal UPSC mein, IAS mein kabhi nahi aa sakta. In history, we only discuss which happened, why happened, when happened, where happened, and with what consequences. We can never discuss what could have happened. This can only be discussed by poet. क्या भाई दफ्तर तुम होती तो ऐसा होता, तुम होती तो वैसा होता, तुम इस बात पे हैरान होती, उस बात पे परेशान होती. मूवी सिलसिला 1980, यश चोपड़ा इज डायरेक्टेड. माय जॉब इज आल्सो टू एनहांस हिज जनरल नॉलेज अदर देन हिस्ट्री. सो पोएट कैन इमेजिन कि तुम होती तो ऐसा होता. हिस्ट्री कैन नॉट बी रिटन कि जिना नहीं होते तो पाकिस्तान नहीं होता, गांधी नहीं होते तो देश आजाद नहीं होता, ब्रिटिश नॉर्थ आते तो रेलवे नहीं होता. Are you getting or not? तो मुझे याद है when I started teaching history in my university during tea break, non-history का जो teacher होता है जैसे science का, engineering का, तो एक biotech के professor हैं, बहुत senior हैं, तो अक्सर मुझसे अजीब-अजीब सवाल करते थे. So initially I was very terrified, I was much junior to him. तो उनके सवाल से I was sometimes I was feeling कि do really I do not know or he is doing some game. Once he asked, बताओ अगर 47 में इंडिया पार्टीशन नहीं होता तो क्या होता? I was just wondering and then I said क्या होता सर? वसीम अकरम तेंदुलकर एक ही टीम में खेलता, मैं लाहौर में पढ़ा रहा होता, आप कराची में पढ़ा रहे होते. You didn't know. I mean this is all I can guess. Then एक बार उसने पूछा, can you tell when did Jinnah cry first time? मैंने सर हिस्ट्री में कहीं नहीं पढ़ा ये कि जिन्ना पहली बार शायद जब पैदा हुआ तो रोया होगा. दैट्स व्हाट आई सेड. नहीं नहीं यू डोंट नो. वो जब उसकी गर्लफ्रेंड छोड़ के गई थी तब वो रोया था. मैंने कहा सर हम लोग बेडरूम तक नहीं जाते कि हम ड्राइंग रूम तक ही रहते हैं. कैरेक्टर के गांधी हो या नेहरू हो या अकबर हो. सो नॉन हिस्ट्री पीपल टेक मोर इंटरेस्ट इन अदर पार्ट बिकॉज दे डोंट हैव दैट सेंस ऑफ हिस्ट्री. In UPSC, first thing you should know what they are looking in a boy and girl who is 23, 24, 25 years, and what they are looking, a mind which is this side fully developed, this side even if it is half developed, the rest half they would fill at Mussoorie, Hyderabad or New Delhi. Are you getting not? But if this is half, it's very different. Most student in Mukherjee Nagar, Rajendra Nagar, Anna Nagar in Chennai and Ashok Nagar in Hyderabad are busy in filling left side. And unfortunately, most of the coaching institutes are also engaged in filling left side. Since I am in university, so my basic task is to develop your right side. Left side, you can easily get on your own because today, collection of information is not a big deal. In ancient time, the people who were great who had information. Because information was very limited to limited people. Knowledge was confined to elite. You get my point? So the poor had no access to knowledge. Knowledge started spreading only after printing machine. You're getting my point or not? Printing machine came first time in Europe in 16th century. Bible was the first book, I hope you heard it, which was printed. Before that, say Rig Veda, it would have one copy or two copy. And only a very big pandit of Banaras would have master copy and he would never give you. And he would train some other pandit and they would chant and then you would be terrified in Islamic country. Quran, it was only confined to Maulvida. In Christians, only to Pope and Bishop, and the ordinary Christians had no knowledge about Bible. So in those days, Gurujis were confined to holy places, whether Makkah for Muslims, or Kashi for Hindu, or Haridwar. Today you can download Guruji. You can even delete Guruji if you don't like this one. So today, the problem is just opposite. How to filter the knowledge. So the powerful people are today those who can filter. Just check your WhatsApp from morning to evening. If you just start opening, reading and watching video game, now imagine what would happen after 6 months to you, that you are guided by someone else. Your script is written by someone else completely. So I have made a rule, and many of my professors have done it, that we are not reading except the jokes coming on. Jokes to just for entertainment. But if they are giving a quotation from Bible and Quran and Bhagavad Gita, so that is at our home, why shall I read your WhatsApp, one quotation, and that too with the guideline that forward 10 more. Have you noticed this or not? So this means that today you are enslaved of bombarding of information. And most students are struggling to just segregate the pearl and garbage. That you are full of garbage over a pearl and you don't know that exactly. If you go to here in Mukherjee Nagar, and the materials if you see on the pavement, and if you take it, you imagine you can become a historian but never an IAS. So the first fundamental rule here in IAS is, if you have 10 books at home, donate 9, read one book, but read 10 and read that one book which is the best textbook available in India. So in history I will tell you, in geography other teachers would tell, economy other teacher would tell, one book of topmost historian is must to read to know the depth of the subject. One class note is almost must now, that is because of the area of general studies in the last 5 years has expanded, that if you do on your own, you can definitely do it, but in 3 to 4 years. That 3 to 4 years of your labor is going to be reduced to 700 hours by 8-9 teachers. And that is because they have acquired those knowledges and an expertise how to condense it in 120 hours of each subject, so that those who have studied history or never studied history shall in the next 120 hours know about ancient, medieval, modern and world history with certain degree of confidence that you can write 200 words and you can talk 3 minutes on Hitler, to Mahatma Gandhi, to Buddha, to cow vigilante, to women empowerment, to environment, to any issue in the world which is called anything under the sun. You must know